The city was alive with lights and sounds on the hot summer night. Vian, a bold and adventurous young woman, had scored an invitation to a swanky rooftop party with a stunning view of the skyline. She was ready to have some fun and meet new people. The music was thumping and the atmosphere was buzzing with energy and excitement. As Vian explored the party, she felt a pair of eyes watching her. She turned and saw a man with beautiful eyes. He was Park Jimin, a notorious billionaire who had a reputation for being charming and mysterious. He was leaning against the railing of the rooftop holding a glass of his drink. Vian didn't know about his identity because she was invited by her boss. She had very less interest in billionaire or any rich man. She thought that he would be a simple employee like her in any company. Vian felt a spark of interest and decided to approach him, drawn by his captivating presence. She smiled and greeted him, and they hit it off right away, as if they were old friends. So, Jimin, what's your story? How did you end up at this fancy party tonight? Well, Vian, I'm always looking for new experiences and opportunities. I like to keep things interesting. I got the invitation of this party, so I thought, why not have some fun? How about you? What made you come here? I guess I'm the same way. I love trying new things and meeting new people. I think that's how we grow and learn. Besides, I was invited by my boss. She wants me to join her in this party. I agree, Vian. There's something thrilling about venturing into the unknown, don't you think? Head down, push forward through the tough times, 'cause anything worth doing is a tough climb. And I ain't gonna give up, got too little time. The night was filled with passion and intrigue as Vian and Jimin engaged in a flirtatious game. Their conversation became more personal, their words hinting at hidden fantasies. But Jimin never tell her about his true identity in whole conversation. Jimin, there's a certain spark between us, don't you feel it? It says, if the stars aligned for us to meet tonight. You have a way of captivating me, Vian. It's true, I haven't felt a fire like this in a long time. Destiny has a funny way of bringing people together. And what do we do when destiny gives us such a chance? We can either ignore it or we can seize it fully, without hesitation. Life is too short for what ifs, Vian. As the night turned into morning, Ryan and Jimin found themselves on the balcony, away from curious eyes. The moon shone upon their faces, creating a magical atmosphere around them. Jimin, this night feels like a fairy tale. Let's make it truly memorable. Ryan, I want nothing more than to discover every secret of your heart tonight, to surrender ourselves to the desire that flows between us. Ryan blinked her eyes open, feeling a dull ache in her body. She stretched her arms and legs, feeling the soft silk sheets caressing her skin. She smiled, remembering the passionate night she had with Jimin, the handsome man she had met at the party. He had swept her off her feet with his charm and charisma, and they had ended up in the luxurious room of the hotel where the party was held. She turned to look for him, expecting to see his handsome face and his tousled hair on the pillow next to her, but he was gone. The bed was empty, except for a note and a single red rose. She felt a pang of disappointment and curiosity. She reached for the note and read it. Ryan, I'm sorry. I had to leave so early. I had an important meeting to attend. I hope you understand. You were amazing last night. You made me feel things I've never felt before. You're beautiful, smart, and funny. You're everything I ever dreamed of. But you deserve better than me. I'm not good for you. I'm a busy person, always traveling and working. I hid from you last night about my identity. I'm a CEO of Korea's biggest fashion clothing company. I can't give you the attention and love you need. I can't be your boyfriend. Please don't hate me. Please don't cry. Please don't try to find me. It's better this way. Just remember this night as a sweet memory that we both enjoyed. Thank you for everything, Jimin. Ryan felt tears sting her eyes as she read the note. She couldn't believe it. He was gone, just like that. He didn't even say goodbye in person. He didn't even give her a chance to say anything. She clutched the note and the rose to her chest, feeling a mix of emotions, anger, sadness, confusion, regret. She wanted to scream, to call him, to beg him to come back. But she knew it was useless. He had made up his mind. He had left her. But she couldn't. He was unforgettable. A few weeks later, Ryan felt sick. She had been throwing up every morning, feeling dizzy and tired. She had missed her period too. She had a bad feeling about it. She decided to buy a pregnancy test and take it at home. She locked herself in the bathroom, holding the test in her hand. She followed the instructions and waited for the result. She felt nervous and scared. What if she was pregnant? What would she do? How would she raise a child alone? How would she tell Jimin? Would he even care? She looked at the test and gasped. It was positive. She was pregnant. She dropped the test on the floor, feeling shocked and overwhelmed. She slid down the wall, hugging her knees to her chest. She started to cry, feeling hopeless and helpless. She didn't know what to do. She felt like her life was over. She stayed in the bathroom for a long time, trying to calm down and think clearly. She knew she had to make a decision. She had to face the reality. She had to tell Jimin. She took out her phone and searched for his number. She had saved it before their night together, hoping he would call her again. He never did. She wondered if he had changed his number or blocked her. She hoped not. She hoped he would answer her call. She dialed his number and waited for him to pick up. She heard a few rings, then his voice. Hello? She recognized his voice instantly. It was smooth like honey. It made her heart flutter and ache at the same time. Jimin, she said his name softly, hoping he would remember her. There was a pause, then a confused reply. Who is this? He didn't remember her. He didn't recognize her voice. She felt a surge of anger and hurt. It's me, Vian. She said her name louder, hoping he would recall their night together. There was another pause, then a surprised response. Vian, the girl from the party? He remembered her. He remembered their night together. She felt a mix of relief and resentment. Yes, Jimin, the girl from the party? She said her name again. What do you want? He sounded cold and annoyed. She felt offended and insulted. I need to talk to you, she said firmly, trying to sound confident. About what? He sounded impatient and bored. She felt nervous and scared. About us, she said hesitantly, trying to find the right words. Us, there is no us, he said harshly, cutting her off. She felt hurt and angry. Yes, there is, Jimin, she said defiantly, raising her voice. No, there isn't, Vian, he said firmly, lowering his voice. Yes, there is, Jimin, because I'm pregnant, she blurted out the truth, hoping he would believe her. There was silence on the other end of the line, then a loud gasp. What? Vian repeated herself, hoping he had heard her. I'm pregnant, Jimin. I'm pregnant with your child, she said softly, feeling a lump in her throat. There was another silence on the other end of the line, then a loud laugh. You're kidding, right? He said mockingly, sounding amused. She felt offended and hurt. No, I'm not kidding, Jimin. I'm serious, she said firmly, sounding hurt. He laughed again. Come on, Vian. Don't play games with me. You can't be pregnant, he said casually, sounding confident. She felt angry and betrayed. No, we didn't, Jimin. You didn't use anything. You lied to me, she said, sounding bitter. He stopped laughing. What? What are you talking about? Of course I used something, I always do, he said defensively, sounding unsure. She shook her head, feeling disgusted. No, you didn't, Jimin. I know you didn't. I checked the trash can after you left. There was nothing here. You tricked me, she said angrily. He was silent for a moment, sounding guilty. Vian, he said softly, sounding guilty. She cut him off, feeling curious. Don't play with me, Jimin. You lied to me, you used me, you left me, and now you are denying your responsibility? She said bitterly, sounding furious. He sighed. Vyan, listen to me. I'm sorry for everything, but you have to understand. I can't be a father. I can't be with you. It's too complicated. 2 complicated? What's so complicated about it? You got me. You have to take responsibility, she said, sounding hopeless. Vyan, please don't make this harder than it already is. You know I can't do that. I have a career to think about. I have a reputation to protect. I have a fiance to marry, he said desperately, sounding annoyed. A fiance? You have a fiance? She said, sounding shocked and heartbroken. He hesitated, sounding guilty. Yes, I do, he said, sounding guilty. She felt tears streaming down her face, feeling devastated and betrayed. How could you do this to me? How could you do this to us? She sobbed, feeling devastated and betrayed. He sighed again, sounding sorry. Vyan, I'm sorry, I'm so sorry, but it's the truth. I have a fiance, her name is Runa. She's the daughter of the CEO of my rival company. We've been engaged since we were kids. It's an arranged marriage. It's a business deal, he explained, sadly sounding sorry. A business deal? Is that what you call it? A business deal? You're marrying someone you don't love for money and power? She said, sounding disgusted. Hey, don't judge me. You don't know anything about me. You don't know anything about my life. You don't know anything about the pressure I face every day. You don't know anything about the expectation I have to meet. You don't know anything about the sacrifices I have to make. And you don't know anything about me. You don't know anything about my feelings. You don't know anything about my dreams. You don't know anything about my hopes. You don't know anything about the love I have for you. Love? You love me? He said, sounding surprised and confused. Yes, I do. I love you, Jimin. I've loved you since the first time I saw you. I've loved you since the first time we kissed. I've loved you since the first time. I love you more than anything in this world, she said sincerely, sounding surprised and embarrassed. Vyan, he said softly, speechless and stunned. Jimin, please don't marry her. Please marry me. Please be with me. Please be a father to our child. Please give us a chance. Please choose us, she said pleadingly, sounding hopeful and desperate. Vyan, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do. I'm sorry, he said hesitantly, sounding conflicted and torn. I see. You've made your choice then. You've chosen her over me. You've chosen your company over our child. You've chosen your business deal over my love, she said bitterly, sounding disappointed and heartbroken. Vyan, please don't say that. It's not that simple. It's not that easy. It's not that black and white. Yes, it is. It is that simple. It is that easy. It is that black and white. You either love me or you don't. You either want me or you don't. You either care about our child or you don't, she said firmly, sounding determined and angry. Vyan, I can't do that. I can't leave her. I can't be with you. I can't be a father to our child, he said weakly, sounding hesitated and scared. Then goodbye, Jimin. Goodbye forever, she said coldly, sounding disgusted and done. She hung up the phone, feeling empty and numb. She threw the phone on the bed, feeling angry and hurt. She grabbed her bag, determined and brave, she left the apartment. She walked out the apartment feeling lost and broken. She hailed a taxi, hopeless and desperate. She told the driver to take her to the airport ready and decided. She bought a ticket to New York, feeling adventurous and reckless. She boarded the plane, scared and excited too. She left Korea to be free and alive. Jimin didn't marry Runa, feeling guilty and confused. He tried to find Wayan. He searched everywhere. He was desperate and hopeless. He couldn't forget her. He missed her. He was lonely and miserable. He regretted his decision. He felt foolish and stupid. He wanted her back. Finally, he found her through a mutual friend who had moved to New York and kept in touch with Wayan. He asked the friend for Wayan's address and phone number, but the friend refused to give them to him. He begged the friend to at least tell him where Wayan worked, and the friend unwillingly agreed. He flew to New York, feeling determined and brave. He went to Wayan's workplace, an internet and computer cafe, and waited for her to finish her shift. He saw her walking out of the cafe with their baby in a stroller, and he followed her until he caught up with her. He called her name and she turned around shocked to see him. Wayan, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for everything. I'm so sorry for hurting you. I'm so sorry for leaving you. I'm so sorry for not being there for you. I'm so sorry for not being father to our child. She listened to him, conflicted and torn. Jimin, why are you here? Why did you come? Why did you look for me? Why did you find me? Wayan, I'm here because I love you. I came because I need you. I look for you because I miss you. I found you because I want you. Jimin, how can I trust you? How can I believe you? How can I forgive you? How can I be with you? Then he begged her, feeling humble and vulnerable. Wayan, please trust me. Please believe me. Please forgive me. Please be with me. Give me another chance. Let me be a part of your life. Let me be a father to our child. Please let me be your husband. She hesitated, feeling tempted and moved. Jimin, are you sure? Are you serious? Are you ready? Are you willing? Wayan, yes, I'm sure. Yes, I'm serious. Yes, I'm ready. I'm willing. You know, I left Runa because, Wayan, I love you more than anything in this world. Wayan, please say yes. I want to be with you and our baby. She smiled, happy and hopeful. Yes, Jimin. Yes. He hugged her, relieved. She hugged him back, feeling safe and loved. He kissed her with passion and tenderness, and she responded with warmth and sweetness. You know, I named our baby boy Jihu because I never forget you. He looked just like you. Monster out of my head, under my bed, thinking something. Out of my nightmares, see me. He held Jihu in his arms, amazed and proud of the miracle they had created. She looked at them with gratitude and joy, feeling the bond that united them. They walked together hand in hand, feeling happy and complete. They were ready to start a new life, strong and proud of their love. Love is not only something you feel, it is something you do. You don't ever wanna set me free. You know I'm addicted to you, and it's twisted. You've been gifted with the evil voodoo. Got me coming back for more, even when I've been screwed. Dolls full of pins, pierce my heart straight through. I got issues in my head. I like you in my bed, but you keep me on red. Oh, everything is like a test. I better not text, or I'll come off desperate. What if I